WSAB and community partner McDonald's present Weatherwise Kids.
I'm Walt. I'm from PHA. How does a barometer work?
Hey Walt, thanks for the question. A barometer is one of the most important weather instruments because it helps to predict short-term weather changes. The weight of the air above us is called air pressure. A barometer tells you whether the air pressure is rising or falling. A rising barometer means sunny and dry conditions, while a falling barometer means stormy and wet conditions. Barometers measure air pressure in inches of mercury or in millibars. An Italian scientist named Torricelli built the first barometer in 1643. But like all technology, this instrument has seen major improvements over the years. The barometers used today are completely electronic and show the pressure reading on an LCD screen. The simplest kind of a barometer is a tall, closed tube standing upside down in a dense liquid metal called mercury. At sea level, the atmosphere will push down on the mercury, making it rise up in the tube to a height of about 30 inches. The higher the pressure, the higher the mercury will climb in the tube. Therefore, the lower the pressure in the atmosphere, the less the mercury will rise. This type of barometer is useful and accurate, but mercury is poisonous. So a more common type of barometer is called the aneroid barometer. Instead of having a pool of mercury that the atmosphere pushes down on, aneroid barometers have a sealed airtight metal box inside. As the air pressure rises or falls, the box either pushes inward or flexes out. A spring is attached to the box, and as the box moves in and out, the spring moves to the pointer on the dial. The dial is marked with numbers so you can read the air pressure right away. If it moves clockwise up the dial, the pressure is increasing, so the weather is likely getting warmer and drier. If the needle turns counterclockwise, the pressure is decreasing, and the weather is likely getting cooler and wetter. For WeatherWise Kids, I'm meteorologist Ariella Scalise.